on the button. My finger is on the button. My finger is on the button.
Push the button.
Thank you. so totally lost. If I'm asking for help, it's only because being with you has opened my eyes. Could I ever believe such a perfect surprise? I keep asking myself, wondering how. I keep closing my eyes, but I can't look you out. Wanna fly to a place where it's just you and me, nobody else, so we can be free.
e-gaming bets. We accept bets on computer games online since 2011. Referral system for regular users and the first deposit bonus. Gaming devices store and the best choice of payment systems. Dota 2 and Hearthstone, Counter-Strike and StarCraft, World of Tanks and League of Legends. EGB.com. You know for sure who's going to win.
G2A.com, the best video game store ever! Fast as lightning! Solid as a rock! Cheap as duck! What's more, you can sell on it because it's also a marketplace. Remember G2A.com, the best video game store ever.
Welcome, Counter-Strike fans, to the second season of the Counterpit League. I'm, of course, Jim Inesso, and joining me in the hot seat today is none other than the Thunder from Down Under, the man they call PDG. How you going this morning, Pete? It's 4 a.m, well, effectively, in here in Australia.
Yeah, it's a beautiful morning to be casting Counter-Strike for us, but in the European time zone, it's a lovely time for playing games, as we see the SK versus Pentagram match just slightly moved back due to the inavailability of Penta this morning. So now we have SK Gaming taking on CSGO Lounge in a match that certainly should deliver, but SK should be looking to forge ahead here and deliver the goods here against CSGO Lounge. I believe the maps are Mirage and Train, but certainly two very talented rosters coming up against each other this morning.
That is certainly the case, as we see both of these guys go head to head and obviously push their match forward. Now, the interesting part for me is the fact that this fresh SK lineup have obviously had their first counterpit match, whereas CSGO Lounge are actually making their debut in the competition. So they'll be keen to get themselves off both tides to get to a good start. Obviously, SK winning their first matchup. But they're not messing about too much, actually. They're going straight into the pistol.
Yeah, and it will be CSGO Lounge starting on the CT side of things, as the SK boys make their way up the short catwalk now, and they're going to put pressure on the mid window and also short. But Innocent and Jero open up nicely onto Pimpin' Magic, and before FR gets the trade onto Innocent. Now Motti doing what he does best and picking up the headshot on Mishu before eventually his teammate also takes down Jero. So now we're left at a 2v2 here to start this action off tonight. And the player Manice is definitely someone to look out for, as he spots out Motti and takes him down with the bomb also. So fantastic work there by Manice, the new addition to the CSGO Lounge roster, even if he is only a temporary fix at the moment. Hopefully he cements his spot in the team, and with frags like that, he's going a long way towards doing so. But at the moment, it's just a 2v1 here, and FR is finding it difficult to find a kill at the moment. And Manice should wait him out here, takes him down, and a great start to the evening's events here for CSGO Lounge, going one up in the pistol.
That was a really rapid start, actually. I guess that's the tale of this map so far, or this matchup so far. Of course, Freest not able to do too much there, being on such low HP, had to collect a bomb from the middle and try and make his way to his site, but they will now, as a result of not winning the round, they're actually going to buy up and force the issue here at SK, so they are going to go with the Tech-9 and armor buy up, so I'd be interested to see whether or not they can hit this B site with brute force as we look at the overlay there. They are
And Manice has spotted them out, so here comes the progression here from SK, jumping through that window, trying to get in the site, but brilliant defense here coming in from Manice, and also the CSGO Lounge teammates there. Mishu picks up a pretty cheeky, easy double with the Famous there, so everything's left up to one member of SK. Of course, the famous line from the from the Spawn Clutch back on the original Cobblestone so long ago, SK, with such an amazing history in Counter-Strike, the series of games, and it's good to see that they've got a pretty good lineup here that can do some damage with players like Pimp Motti and Freeze coming to the party. So, but CSGO Lounge at the moment going up 2-2-0 will be the SK boys on a full eco round here. They won't even invest a single penny in this one, saving their time and money for the next round, and CSGO Lounge should clean this one up easy. Does it now, and it looks to be the case. And Jim, this is the start that CSGO Lounge desperately needed this morning, well, this evening, against SK.
It's been very, very rapid to start here, and Mihu just cleaning up those eco frags ever so well. Obviously, they didn't lose anyone in that round either, so it was a really clean anti-eco, but of course, they've really got to navigate the gun round where I guess most of the action and the next couple rounds really hinge on. So they are, of course, taking some really fast mid-control, and I think really just taking SK by surprise here. They forced the issue as they send members up short. Now, they've actually had three on B and really forced the issue here. Of course, Mihu actually dealing with Majisk Boy quite well in the B site, and of course, nullifying the threat that they pose.
Yeah, Majisk Boy doing a great job there of taking that too. Didn't expect the third one, but what he's done is forced the rotation from CSGO Lounge to come in, and they've made their way through CT towards B. But Innocent putting up good defense here in CT spawn to stop this A progression from SK. But as it stands, Motti and Freeze are going to find their way into the site to try and get the bomb down. But not before a bit of spam comes through there from Innocent. The bomb will go down. Freeze doing a great job there of getting in a good position. But both CTs have found their way to spawn. And Mishu there picking up a fantastic headshot onto Motti, who's a very dangerous player himself. But is a great plant for the last remaining T. And Mishu now smoking off mid. So there's an opportunity here for the CSGO Lounge boys to get straight on the bomb. And that defuse angle isn't going to help the T trying to get it done at all. He does pick up Innocent, and he might think that's the defuser, but he's not going to have the right angle. Mishu grabs the defuse, and CSGO Lounge with, I guess it was a bit shaky there, but picking up their fourth round and continuing their momentum. And now we see the first AWP for the game onto Jero, as, of course, SK look to once again force buy off the back of that plan.
Well, they are absolutely hitting this match at a blistering pace, SK. They're taking everything so quickly, and of course, CSGO Lounge are dealing with it really well. And I think this is something you really see from teams like Fnatic, who really like to try and force the issue and try and run at you, basically until you can stop it. And of course, CSGO Lounge are dealing with it quite well, so SK might need to try and revise their approach. But things are breaking down across the map. They haven't really maintained mid-control just yet, but they are trying to push themselves into the connector.
Yeah, SK need to change it up a little bit here, and that's exactly what they're doing. They've taken that fast pace they've brought to the first four rounds, and they've just decided to slow it down a bit as Pimp makes his way towards the window room ladder area, and he will get in there, but Innocent pretty content on just staying in that window room and staying alive, making his going to be a nuisance later on in the round as Freeze makes his way up mid and tries to spot that window player, but Innocent's not going to have a bar of it, and Jerry will pick up that AWP kill onto Freeze, so good start to the round there once again by CSGO Lounge as the progression looks like it's coming in towards A, and it will be a double AWP kill as Mouse also picks up Majisk Boy, and now it's all left up to Pimp to try and make this work, but he's going to probably save this one, only 30 seconds to go. And not really an ideal situation for him to be in as Mishu picks up Pimp. And as you said, mate, only about 10 minutes in game and already CSGO Lounge on 5-0. So they're getting off to a very, very quick start here.
Yeah, they really do have the jump on SK Gaming at the moment. SK just not really doing anything terribly well coordinated. That's the pure and simple fact at the moment as they really try and at the moment, this is the first time I've seen them coordinatedly hit a site as some frags come in there. Of course, Motti finding Malzinho and being cleaned up himself before Innocent can do the job. Now, the smokes will come in on that site. More importantly, CSGO Lounge don't actually have anybody sitting on that CT ramp, so they're allowed free passage into that site. As Jero actually picks up a frag there before Majisk Boy can try and push his way through. Great frag onto Mihu sitting on the city ramp as they do get the bomb down. There's a fantastic eco from these guys so far, and they do have rifles themselves. So Jarrett misses his shot at the Majestic Boy. Might not get another chance as he steps around the corner, takes the head of Innocent and a second as well. Minis going down. Majestic Boy with the triple. That is fantastic from him. The quad K coming out, and of course the first round for SK.
Yeah, brilliant crosshair placement there from the SK player, just transferring his aim nicely from target to target to target there, taking down three in quick succession. But I like the look of the CSGO Lounge AWPing situation here. They've still got two AWPs up, so Manis and also Spero, I believe, is the way to pronounce that one. He's tagged up as Gero and or Gero, but I think it's Spero, the star player for CSGO Lounge, and he's started extremely well on 8-3, and with that AWP in hand, he's hit a couple of nice shots before the SK player was able to make that round work. But SK on the board now, so momentum starting to finally trickle a little bit their way as Moddy holds the ground there on ARM, making sure nothing gets in. But Mishu will find the forcing pimp into the window room, but at the moment, SK just pretty content with holding back and not really forcing the issue too much, but SK will find their way back into the window room, and now Mishu goes down. So now it's a 4v4 before Freeze finds Manis trying to pick into the short mid area, and he will get taken down. Now it's a 4v3 situation, and SK on the front foot really need to consolidate this round.
As they do find the frag there, Moddy now opening up this A site. The two remaining CTs are going to be forced to defend it here. Innocent getting one, Majestic Boy settling that score. Spero actually finding Cillian in mid as they now make their way into this A site. They need to make the cross here. Of course, those flashes just preventing Spero from actually getting any vision onto that A site. They will get that bomb down. Majestic Boy will position himself quite well here on the CT ramp, and Freeze is just aware of the presence, potentially, of Spero in that mid-connector.
Yeah, and Freeze has got a great idea of the whereabouts of his counterpart, Spero, as Freeze picks the nice angle there, baits out the shot from Spero, and takes him down with that AWP. So, SK, back-to-back rounds here, although the money situation for CSGO Lounge is still decent. They will force this one up with the AWP going on to Spero once again. Mishu and Maus will have the rifles with Innocent and Minis just picking up those CZs, and they're going to try and force this one and get the job done. But SK Gaming with a good push there. Spero goes down, and that is the AWP down. So good start to the round here for SK as they work their way just... looks as though they're going to work towards mid, but Magic Boy, who's done so well in that B corridors, has gone down to Manis in that CZ. And we've got some decision-making to do here for SK, and you can see they're quickly on the rotate back towards this A-bomb site, and this is an excellent read. We've got Pimp left in that mid-con, making sure that the CT rotation doesn't come in too quickly, but it's all going to be on Maus to try and defend this, this push here. But SK Gaming just a little hesitant, backing off now, leaving two members at A, and now it looks as though Moddy and Freeze are going to find their way back towards the B side of things with the bomb. Of course, Mishu and Manis still lurking as Mishu pushes mid now, actually. So he's going to take the fight on with Pimp, and Pimp's going to come out the better in that duel, taking him down before Innocent does spot out Pimp. And the CTs are definitely thinking it's going to be an A hit here, but the bomb is going to go down. But Manis, great positioning there, will get the bomb down. Now Moddy and his teammate forced into this 3v2 situation, but Moddy will pick up the first kill and the bomb. Now this is a big opportunity here for SK to force CSGO Lounge onto the eco, and Jim, it's a 2v2 with Moddy on only 13 HP.
That bomb has gone down though, so this round is at least on a timer. Of course, we have the advantage of the overlay here, so we can see that Innocent and Mauzinho are going to make their way into the site. Great frag there from Massilian, really forcing the issue now. Innocent's only got that AWP, of course. We'll try and potentially look for another gun here, but Moddy's playing this quite well. He's the man that's getting the information as to where he could be in that site, and knows that he's not on the bomb. He does tap it, and one of them will have to force, as that Moddy with a great no-scope there onto Innocent in the site. Really doing a good job at the moment now, SK, of steadying the ship and getting those T rounds. So Of course, at their start, they were looking really disjointed, but now it seems that they've almost seemingly started working as a team and really forcing the issue here. CSGO Lounge, of course, on an eco.
Yeah, and it's a good opportunity as CSGO Lounge go on the eco to just give some perspective on this SK lineup. Pimp, of course, such a talented player, and he's got a very lucrative offer with SK Gaming at the moment, but the player who won that last round, Motti, he's had such a fantastic history in Counter-Strike, the series. Of course, 1.6 star player, but always had issues with, I guess, personality clashes and his ability to gel with different rosters, and at the moment, he looks like he's settling in well with SK, and they're doing pretty well, getting 3 rounds on the board so far, and it'll be Manice just trying to get that deagle kill, but a beautiful clean round there for SK, losing no guns, Pimp on 4 HP, but their money situation looks great at the moment for SK, and CSGO Lounge is forcing the issue here. They've got a full buy-in, good utility and armor and everything there on the side of CSGO Lounge, but SK mixing up the pace well here, and the AWP going on to freeze, so expect the B pick here as we see the AWPer for SK making his way into the B halls to potentially try and get that pick early. It's been Magic Boy's role to get that kill and action going at the B side, but Freeze is tagged in and will find one, so great change up there from SK, sending that AWP into the B side and picking up the early frag in the round, and once again, they're content with just picking up that man advantage and slowing it down before deciding which side to hit.
They have, and Mihu finds a reply frag there onto Freeze, so that AWP has been eliminated in the B halls there, and if Innocent's not careful, he could find himself running into a Cillian here. Of course, able to get that frag as well, so good job from Innocent there. Great reactions from him. Just recognizing there could be someone potentially boosted into that middle window, as now we see things really break down for SK Gaming. They're just being picked apart and just reverting to that individual style that, I guess, essentially lost them their first four rounds. But it's now on to Pimp and Motti to try and combine here at this A site to firstly get the plant and then try and win out that round for SK.
If you want two players alive from SK, it's going to be Motti and Pimp, though, in a 2v4. They've got 30 seconds left on the clock, and they're going to make their way into this A bomb site. Pimp does spot at one, takes him down, but Moose has found Motti there, so it's now a 3v1, and Pimp is in the A bomb site. He has been spotted, too, so this is danger signs here for Pimp, but he picks up the first one. He needs one more kill, but time is of the essence. He's got 12 seconds and must make a play. You can see him committing to the plant now, and Spero's in an excellent position to just take him down after he plants. He does. Nice patience there and teamwork, waiting for his teammate Mishu to come to his aid. Spero taking him down. We'll jump on the defuse. And CSGO Lounge pick up another round, and they'll go up 6-4.
Yeah, good work from SK, though, in that situation, to at least get the bomb down and then kill a further two members of CSGO Lounge. So SK at least putting pressure on the CT economy here. Of course, getting the plant, which stimulates their own economy. But as we have said a few times in our cast, that if you're going to lose a round, at least kill three members of the CT. That way, their economy is at least going to be affected in some way. So as we see now, SK Gaming able to buy on the back of that bomb plant. And CSGO Lounge just struggling a little bit, at least in terms of utility there, as we see a few members missing head armor.
But SK will make their way quickly into B, and this is a great change of pace once again from Team SK. They've forced their way into the B bomb site immediately, sending two halls and three up short, with the cover of smoke. Now CSGO Lounge will be locked out of this B bomb site, licking their wounds. So Spero, Innocent, and Mouse will all try and save their weapons, I should think. Yeah, definitely the course of action here is Innocent does pick up an exit kill, but great read there from SK, just acknowledging the fact that not only had Freeze picked up that AWP kill last round, actually Magic Boy had done a great job taking down the enemy players at B, so SK just sensing that the holes in the defense of CSGO Lounge may have rested the B bomb site and going immediately there and winning the round. So 6-5 is the score for CSGO Lounge versus SK, and SK is doing a great job of getting back in this match.
Exactly right. You identified it perfectly, that they've been fragging out on that B site so constantly, and recognizing that that was around where the CT economy was going to be under so much pressure that chances are they were not going to have the utility to try and defend a fast push into that site. And as we saw, they got in without too much trouble at all, just having to make that frag. Magisk Boy really making things look so easy as they now try and put pressure on mid. CSGO Lounge finding the frag onto Acilian and really pushing them back, at least at the start. Great reply from Pimp, a great little Kobe coming in, as now they're going to hit this A site. Malzinho actually finding two frags as well, so he's doing a really good job of keeping them out. In the meantime, Magisk Boy getting caught on the Tetris, as now things are left on Pimp's shoulders to try and salvage the round. I think at the moment he should just really be looking to do that CT economic damage and find perhaps two frags.
Definitely the situation there for Pimp. He's going to actually go for this. So it's going to be, I mean, SK is in a great situation in terms of their money, so they don't need to be worried about their economy with such a small amount of time left to go in the half, just two rounds at the conclusion of this one. So they're in a great position here, but CSGO Lounge, the ones that can be shaky, and Pimp finds Malzinho. So it'll only be one more kill here for SK, and that'll do the job. Pimp is going to walk his way around the CT spawn area and just try and find any sort of CT action, but Innocent, Manice and Sparrow just holding back and making sure that they don't give their life away so easily. But as it stands, the T player is going to come up the CT spawn and be spotted out there by Innocent. He will get taken down. Pimp doesn't do any more damage there. So CSGO Lounge get their seventh round on the board, and they should be able to buy. But once again, their money is, I guess, very shaky, as Sparrow does get that AWP, so he's looked great with that AWP, and that's a good sign for this round for CSGO Lounge. But SK's money is in a good position now, so they're going to force the buy up as well, get that AWP onto Freeze and try and do some damage here in the start of the round, as you can see two players of SK quickly making their way towards the underside and out the middle of the map. So four members of SK just making their presence felt, I should say, in the midsection. And the one player who's not in mid is taken down by Sparrow, and that's Motti, as Acilion jumps through that smoke and Innocent takes him down. So a really good predictable hold there from CSGO Lounge. They've anticipated well and made a setup accordingly, as Sparrow gets his second for the round and spots out a third. Will he be the greedy type and go for the pick? He's going to jump up on the boxes first of all to get a better angle on this, the mid-con player, but Sparrow already with the double and looking great with that AWP.
And just on the breakdown there, of course, Manice just making things look a little too easy with the cleanup job, final last two members of SK Gaming. Until that round, SK Gaming were doing a really good job of putting pressure on the CT economy. Of course, not losing too much that last round really just sees them now start to stabilize their economy for the last couple rounds of the half. And I think that was really the round where SK could have applied the asset to CSGO Lounge and just really forced that issue, as we now see them take that fast mid control that they were, keen on doing earlier in the half. Frags come in. Mihu actually finding a frag of his own onto Pimp in mid. Motti's able to find that frag, of course, onto Manice. And now Acilion just catching Innocent there in the mid connector, as they make their way onto this B site. Great entry frag there from Motti, and leaving all to do for Mihu and Malzinho, as Malzinho is actually a long way away from the action here, but he will run into Acilion, who is trying to lurk him. Unfortunately, not able to do so. Oh, Magisk Boy just seeing the fishing rod, the tip of Mihu's gun around that pole, and just getting the jump on him there. Malzinho, they know potentially where he is, as he did fell Acilion, should I say, earlier on in this round. So they have an idea that he's potentially at that check room. He's now forced into a 2v1 to really put a lot of pressure back onto SK here. He does check the corner there, finds Motti, and we'll need to find the second. In fact, he does. Magisk Boy going down. So great work from Mazzino. And obviously just being fed some information here as to potentially where an AWP is in that site, but they do find their ninth round on this first half in this best of two. So really good job from Malzinho in that position, and really we'll need to find that 10th round if they're going to keep SK at bay.
Yeah, stunning clutch there from Mazinho as he made his way back into the B bomb site there. But brilliant work opening up B once again by Motti. He picked up the first one very quickly, and Motti will start the action again, taking down Innocent almost immediately to start the round. A brilliant pick there from the star player from SK Gaming, but Spero putting that AWP once again to good use, and Manice chiming in as well. Mishu's gonna find the first one, and there's a second one there in mid-con, so Pimp goes down, but he hasn't managed to spot out the second member, Acilion, making his way through the jungle area, and that will call Spero to go down, and Motti takes out Mazinho. So now, what looked like a great start to the round for CSGO Land just broken down into a 2-versus-2 before Acilion finds Manice. Now, Motti just going back for the bomb, but he's of the opinion that one of the CSGO Lounge players is pushing T-Spawn. Of course, we can see that he's all the way back in mid-con trying to figure out what on earth SK are doing. But great work here by Motti and Acilion. They've regrouped and will make their way back towards the bomb together, just taking their time to grab that one as Mishu's just in the A-Halls area trying to scope out the map and gets clear off some areas before he has to eventually make a correct read and go back towards the B side. But in fact, the T's are running back towards A, so this is the opportunity that Mishu needed to win this round, and the SK guys are going to make their way through the A halls and almost explicitly run into Mishu, and he does get taken down. The second player not expected there, I guess, and Motti gets the triple for the round and also closes it out for SK. 9-6, and I definitely think CSGO Land showed me enough there, Jim, that we might have a very close match on our hands.
Yeah, they showed enough, obviously, going down quite a lot of rounds early in that first half, but of course they're hitting the second half much like they did the first, and CSGO Land actually hitting things at a really fast pace here, as you can see on the overlay. They've actually got five members sitting in the B-Halls early. Malzinho's actually made his way through the underpass there. We'll try and at least distract a few members of SK Gaming, but as you can see on the overlay, they've actually got three members here. Acilion finding that first frag as well, so great headshot from him, picking up from short, and they are making their way onto the site. Innocent finding the opening frag there. Acilion's able to find one more before he's traded out by Spiro, as Freeze finds another frag of his own. The trades are coming through thick and fast. It's starting to look like a Yu-Gi-Oh meet because they're trading just that quickly, but now Motti is dancing around the poles here in the B side, just preventing that bomb from going down. CSGO Lounge actually have to take the fight. Malzinho burning Motti alive to a crisp there. As now a lot to do for the 8 HP Freeze and Pimp, as they are putting the pressure on CSGO Lounge, just preventing them from making that attempted plant, because they know if they do try and plant, they are going to make this a 1-versus-2, as Pimp actually finds that frag onto Spero in the site. Freeze just doing a good job, but the HPs are going to be a massive factor here. One shot each, potentially, from SK Gaming. Freeze now in that checker room, finding the headshot onto Malzinho. Of course, 8 HP, it doesn't really matter when you're hitting headshots like that.
Yeah, Freeze did a great job of staying alive there and making the CSGO Lounge guys really work for those kills. He didn't give his life away, and he's able to connect that headshot and win the round for SK Gaming. So that's the start that they needed on their pistol round, and they look to push on here, and they forced the issue. Freeze and Pimp picking up those rifles with three SMGs that fill out the rest of the SK Gaming guns, as I trip over my words.
It's early, I'll give you a free pass.
It is early here, sorry for that blunder, but CSGO Lounge have picked up five Deagles, so this could be interesting moving forward, because that one-shot potential is really going to put some stress on the SK guys.
I know you will rate this strat 100% as a proponent of the Deagle yourself.
The Desert Eagle is, I guess, the lost art of the pistol round back in 1.6, and I guess Source as well. The Deagle was like the only pistol that was worth buying apart from the default pistols you spawn with. An eco round usually consisted of just those standard USP and Glocks, but you could go for a Deagle if you're feeling adventurous, and the CSGO Lounge guys in fact were feeling that way. But Pimp and Monty get the job done. Not before three players get taken down, but it won't be enough for CSGO Lounge. If you commit to those Deagles, you need to make it work the whole way, and they haven't managed to pick up the round there. So 9-8, CSGO Lounge holding onto a slender lead, but SK building momentum nicely on their CT side.
Yeah, SK just navigating that force buy around so quickly here, as we do see Frisk called into action early on. Finds a frag onto Manice there, and they are just picking into mid and really forcing the issue here. Now, Zinho is able to find a frag with that pistol there, but he's traded out quite soon by Acilion, as Pimp continues to just apply the acid to CSGO Lounge here in middle. And of course, before you know it, they're only down to two members, and there's still a minute 27 left to play in this round. So Mihu actually finding a one bullet deagle frag onto Pimp there in the vent room, and now things just breaking down a little bit. They are aware that CSGO Lounge are going to try and take a little bit of control here in the middle, but if he's not careful, Innocent could run into Magisk Boy as that bomb makes its way on the short catwalk to B.
But it is a 2 versus 3, and Innocent has found himself an M4, so this could be interesting here for SK if the timing is bad. But as it stands, the timing is good for Magisk Boy. He spots out both members of CSGO Lounge, and we'll take down the first one before Acilion there is able to find a good angle and pick up that M4. So 9-9 towards the both teams picking up 9 rounds. And now we move into the first gun round, where Spero doesn't have an AWP, so that's a concern for CSGO Lounge. They've looked at their best when he does, but Freeze has got that AWP in hand, and we'll just see a pretty aggressive move here towards mid. Mihu and Spero just trying to do their best impersonation of a mid take, but the flashes are great there from SK Gaming, just locking them out of that mid early round. And consolidating the hold there, as now Manice finds the first one and gets a lot of damage. Mihu sprays through the smoke and tries to find Acilion just lurking in that middle connector area. And now Innocent will get the boost. And CSGO Lounge, even though it's a 4 versus 4, I do like the position they've got themselves into early on in this round.
Yeah, they are in a great position here to pincer A. Obviously, SK are actually recognizing that. As you can see on the overlay, they've actually bolstered their forces at the A site with, I do believe it's both Moddy and the low HP Acilion just making their way, or should I say Pimp and Acilion sitting there in that A site. They are going to make their way into A, of course, through the mid-connector, jumping through that smoke and putting the pressure on A. Spero and Innocent and Mauzinho actually finding some frags quite well into this A site, but they still have to deal with Moddy, who hasn't been dealt with in that cutout, of course, doing some damage before he went down. CSGO Lounge actually take the lead back off SK here, and starting to just get up a little bit in what has been this fast-paced arm wrestle.
Yeah, and as so often we see on Mirage, Jim, the battle of mid is dictating a lot of the outcome of the round here. So the CSGO Lounge guys, they're able to take control of mid and get in great positions and abuse that mid-con split onto A. And now they're just going to walk up A-ramp together as a team. And I like this change of pace here from CSGO Lounge, and the eco is going to come out for SK, so should be a pretty easy round here to deal with for CSGO Lounge, as the A bomb site's completely left undefended. But Magic will pick up a UMP kill, and Moddy might in fact get that AK. He's not able to reach it at the moment, but he might try and stick his head out and find that one, as Acilion finds Manice in T-spawn, and Innocent is taking care of business in CT-spawn. So it'll just be Acilion and Magic Boy saving these guns, and looking forward to the next round. But it'll be 11-9 for CSGO Lounge, and Jim, they're on their way towards a decent upset here against Team SK.
Yeah, if they can maintain this, this pace, so far what's been a good read of what SK are actually doing with CTs here is Acilion actually loses his gun, Mazinho, so that AK that they worked so hard to get, unfortunately they won't be able to take into the next round. Magisk Boy only able to save what is a UMP. So he did get the money bonus from finding the frag there, of course, but we'll need to try and take that into this next round. As we see though, SK Gaming's money really not good enough to force a full buy, but nonetheless they're going for it. They're going to force this issue.
Yeah, Magic Boy is going to hold on to that UMP and also drop an M4. So SK with a decent buy here. They've got a smoke on almost every player and a couple of Molotovs mixed in with flashes and kits. So they've got a decent little haul here to start the round for SK. They're not going completely unassisted here, but it's going to be an A hit here for CSGO Lounge. You see them just grouping up, ready for those smokes and flashes to rain down as Mauzinho makes his way out of carpet. He's going to be the point man here for CSGO Lounge, but he gets flashed out of it. Manese is just going to charge through this smoke. Great action here from Manese as he fully commits to this smoke push, and he's going to try and find a second one, not before Acilion does find him, but the trading is excellent here for CSGO Lounge's SK Gaming, only able to find one member each as they made their way in, but nevertheless, the trading is good, but Innocent there on the lurk, and now Pimp is stuck in a 2-versus-1. Make that a 1-versus-1 as he spots that Innocent. Can he make the shot? He does.
Oh, Pimp.
Beautiful play there by Pimp. I don't know what you know about me, but this guy picked up a couple of headshots there and able to finish off the round there for SK. CSGO Land still winning 11-10, but signs of life here for SK as Freese gets that all back in his hands.
I heard you couldn't get a dollar out of him.
Well, you know.
But nonetheless, they take that round, of course, on the back of some great work from Pimp. Early trades going down here. Innocent finding a reply onto Freese in that mid-window. Acilion here just with the one-way smoke, but Mihu, well aware of that. As things break down, they do only have four members remaining each team, and this has been the story of this matchup, just how fast-paced things are actually happening. And before you know it, I think barely they've ever navigated the first 10 seconds without ever losing a member, as they now make their way towards this middle and B site. They really don't have a presence anymore at that T ramp, but they are going to look for another frag here, and if they find another frag, they'll do and continue to do what they've done so well. It's just really open up SK Gaming and just force them to either take a gamble on the sites, as Acilion actually takes a gamble and walks out smoke, finding Sparrow before his teammates can find that trade frag. And now just all three members of CSGO Lounge actually sitting in short there. That boost coming through. Pimp, if he's not careful, could find himself under a bit of fire. Does find the frag, and now potentially could be traded out here. Waiting for his teammate Magiscoy to try and help him out. He does find one on the trade, so good work from him there, and leaving Innocent with a lot of work to do to try and make things happen for his team. He does get tagged with that AWP, so left the arm in a 1-versus-2, of course, to Kobe coming in from Motti. Great work from him, and squaring that ledger back now at 11-all, and SK just putting swinging the pendulum back their way.
Yeah, I like the fact that Motti found that AWP, AWP as soon as he could before the round ended. So with that reduced time at the end of each round, it's definitely something that you need to be more aware of now as a player in CSGO. But Freese with that AWP again, and it will be just an A progression here from CSGO Lounge. All players filing at carpet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Acilion. So great work there. He almost got the fourth, but Freese taking that one away from him. So CSGO Lounge just running into a crossfire there, not being able to do a lot, and will be on Innocent with a Deagle to try and win the impossible round and take, I think that there's 493 damage remaining on the SK lineup side of things, and he manages to take not a single point more. That will end the round 12-11 to SK, and they're really starting to hit their groove at the moment.
Yeah, Acilion just licking his lips as the tasty eco frags come in through the palace. And now we do see CSGO Lounge buy on the back of that eco round. They don't have a full range of utility everywhere, but of course they need to keep applying pressure onto SK as they do go for that early mid control. So they are doing a good job of doing that so far. They really have just been passive. Of course, we can see on the overlay that bomb has actually made its way through the B-horse there. And they're going to continue to try and pressure the young member of SK, Magiscoy, only 17 years of age. And what a prodigy he could turn out to be. Obviously, he has the potential to do so, but we've seen a few good performances from him of late.
Yeah, it's a great environment for him to be in as well, playing alongside such experienced members as Pimp, Motti, and Freese. So much he can learn from those guys as SK have taken a chance on quite a young and upcoming player, but he's producing the goods at the moment. And this round is easily the slowest of the game so far. We've got all 10 players still alive as the clock counts down towards 50 seconds to go. And CSGO Lounge does have control of mid, so they're going to try and make this one work up mid-con by the looks of things and force an A split here as Mazinho just patrols that A corridor's area, and he will come out now and find Motti. So great timing there from the CSGO Lounge boys, and Freese picks up Mihu. So now it's a 4-3, and make that a 3-on-3 as Pimp does get a pick there onto one of the players trying to get back to T-spawn, but Manice will escape just by the skin of his teeth here as Freeze jumps up on that box and tries to find a kill, and he won't spot the player out of jungle, but he will spot the player at bomb boxes. So Spero doing a great job there of staying hidden and trading onto Freeze. Now it's a 2-2, and Magic Boy and Pimp will be left alive, and the bomb gets defused before Manice can make his way around. Pros don't fake. Pimp gets it done. And 13-11, SK Gaming, once again, pull out a very, very close round. But a round win is a round win, and they've got 4 on the trot.
That they have, and they're racing away in this second half now, as we see them actually just frantically push on to this A site CSGO Lounge. So they're putting the pressure back now on SK Gaming and doing what they did to CSGO Lounge quite early in that first half, and just changed the pace frenetically. And the bomb's already gone down, and I think there's only been about 15 seconds or so in the round. So SK Gaming have made a really early call here actually to save in this B site. So they're going to try and save their guns as a result of losing members in that A site so early. So really good change of pace here from CSGO Lounge. Really got the jump on SK Gaming, and will now, of course, force the save out of them. They will buy in the next round, and we will see, another potential read coming in from CSGO Lounge. They didn't even lose a member getting onto that site, barely taking any damage at all.
Yeah, I mean, it was completely unexpected there from CSGO Lounge. They just made their way very quickly onto A. And I think something that both teams have done really well this evening is mix up their pace well on T side. Both teams were showed a definite ability to not only take different areas of the map very, very well, but the pace at which they were doing so varied greatly. So the CT defenses were caught off guard regularly, and that's exactly how it should be, as once again, CSGO are going to make their way up the A side of things, but this time SK a little bit more prepared for it. They're going to fight the good fight there at A ramp as Motti picks up a double there from on top of that corner box there in the A site, as now the CSGO Lounge players are going to make their way back towards B, but Magist Boy able to find Manice there, and Freeze will get that scope onto the B halls just in time for Innocent to stop and smell the roses just a little bit there in halls stop and try and... Innocent. Exactly. He's going to try and make a decision on where to go, and two members of SK combined for 13 HP. So if they can find the low members here, it's going to be a tough ask for CSGO Lounge as Acilion gets boosted into that great position inside, and that's going to go completely unnoticed. Pimp finishes off the round, and 14-12 to SK.
Yeah, SK absolutely booking CSGO Lounge there. They actually had 4 members of the CT on that A site, and CSGO Lounge opted for that fast early A control. They tried to get themselves up the T ramp there, but they ran into the wall of SK, and SK then making the great read after that, and able to rotate all their remaining members onto that B site. So we see Freeze here in a position at the mid window, and he's going to come to a front with some of the members of CSGO Lounge now, just only taking a little bit of a tag before he manages to be bullied out of that window. That grenade potentially is going to do some damage there, sitting right on Freeze's nose, down to 32 hit points of health, and that bomb is sitting on the T ramp back towards A, and it looks like they're going to try and pincer A.
Yeah, Mazinho has done a great job coming out of carpet so far in A, and either trading or being the point man for his team. But Acilion there with an aggressive smoke, which I like very much because it stalls CSGO Lounge in their tracks and gives SK Gaming a little bit more time to try and find an enemy player, as Freeze gets a very awkward angle going out of the window room, but it will be Acilion picking up the first kill on Mihu, and now the A progression will come in from CSGO Lounge. No smokes and flashes here, so a bit of a change up, more or less lack of utility there from CSGL, but on the flip side, they have made this work for them very nicely. They're going to make their way into A, finding that kill. Mizinho once again making his presence felt, and SK left with a tough decision, because if they go for this and lose it, they're not going to be in the greatest position to buy in the last round of the game if they force this one up next round. So they've decided that they want to live to see another day. But Manice in a great position there to just trade off onto Magic Boy. And it's a 2-versus-4 situation. But of course, SK aren't going for this at all. They'll save their rifles, lick their wounds, and regroup. Freeze does find a great kill onto Manice, but he could be pressured. He won't be. So this will end the round 14-13. SK Gaming in front, but CSGO Land right there in the mix.
Yeah, they are nipping at their heels. And what they did really well, obviously, was just, again, make the reads, that mid-round read, obviously, to go A and really put pressure there, and ending up coming trumps. But what CSGO Lounge did quite well, and what Manice did, was on that, when they made that call to rotate, they just had that man on the lurk in mid, was able to find that frag. Freeze, just as I said, was able to search for a frag there onto Mihu and push things in the favour of SK Gaming. And if they get themselves onto match point here, a lot of pressure being heaped onto CSGO Lounge. So Manice unable to find that frag in the A site, just tagging, I do believe it was pimped down by quite some margin. So, oh, Sparrow just unscoping at the right, the wrong moment potentially, but he does find that frag nonetheless onto Freeze. Freeze just changing his position with that AWP quite well. Of course, just not being able to find that frag as now things break down. It is a 4-versus-4, and that pressure's coming in from the carpet from Alzinho.
Yeah, and he will get pushed here, so I don't think he's aware that one of the CTs is very, very close to him. He gets flashed. Brilliant, brilliant teamwork there by SK, taking down Alzinho and carpet. But as it stands, the three remaining members of CSGO Lounge are going to find their way into B and get this plant. Is a 3-versus-3 situation, so it's everything on the line here for SK, and I can't believe that CSGO Lounge has made this work so well for them. Innocent picking up a fantastic frag there onto Acilion, and now Motti's going to have to rethink his strategy, but they are still going to go for it by the looks of this. So Motti's interested still, but finally I think they've made the decision to back off. Motti's going to stay in that window room, and Pimp's nowhere to be seen off in CT spawn. So 14-14. It'll be for CSGO Lounge versus SK, and the money situation for SK isn't going to be fantastic moving into this last round.
Yeah, Motti taking a big risk
second
there.
Second last round, I should say.
Yeah, Motti taking a big risk to get that AWP. I'll forgive you. For those of us that are joining in Europe, it's actually 6:26 a.m. in our local time zone, so we are a bit dusty. We are in need of a good coffee blend. But just as we say that, one of these teams is in need of that match point, and these points have come as a result of winning this matchup. Freeze finding that first frag onto Manice in middle, and CSGO Lounge, as we can see on the overlay, sending three members, and now a fourth, to be joined by a fourth, into those B halls. So they're going to put Magisk Boy under a lot of pressure here, or should I say Pimp, as he's going to try and defend this site solo. He does not manage to do so. Freeze is just the one to lock things down in the shop there. Innocent trying to stem that retake here. Coming in from Magisk Boy, putting pressure on them from behind and really keeping two members of CSGO Lounge occupied. In the meantime, Freeze is making his way into the site and does find the close range shotgun AWPing frag onto Mihu. Acilion finding the frag onto Sparrow. And now the two remaining members of CSGO Lounge are in those B halls, and they've got a task on their hands that they're going to try and defend this bomb. SK, though, need to get someone on that defuse. That smoke will come in. Innocent only on numbered HP. 6 HP, single digit. Not able to do much there. Great retake from SK Gaming. And now, match point.
That was just such a crazy round. It was SK's at the start with that early pick, and then it was back in CSGO Lounge's favor, getting that good read and getting into B, and then the brilliant retake from SK. And as we look at the scoreboard, we run from top to bottom. Motti 20, Acilion 22, Pimp 18, Freeze 18, Magic Boy 16. And on the other side of things, Mihu, Sparrow, Moose, and Innocent all cracking just over 20, with Manice on 15. So every player in this game contributing to the scoreboard and to the outcome of each round. So it's incredibly tight, as is reflected on the scoreboard here. SK with a match point. CSGO Lounge need to win this round in order to force an overtime. And strategy of choice in such a pressure situation. Looks as though it'll be an A take here from CSGO Lounge. So SK well prepared for this one as CSGO Lounge make their way up the A ramp and split mid con. So they're splitting this from three different directions. I like this from CSGO Lounge. This is pretty shaky stuff here from SK. They're really going to have to make their shots. Acilion does now the first one, but Mihu replies quickly and Pimp gets that one going onto Mazinho before Spero takes down Modi. So the action coming in thick and fast here. The trading's going crazy as Pimp tries to force his way through the smoke and pick up a kill. He will spot one, but unable to connect with the frag, but now he almost does. Unable to make the kill. That may dictate the outcome of the round, but it won't. Pimp taking on Innocent, Mihu and Spero take it down, and Freeze has picked up a double to close it out for SK. 16-14. That was a nail biter. It was as close as you could possibly get without going overtime. One player left in the 30th round of competition defusing the bomb. That's what we love to see at this level of competition. Brilliant game, and SK Gaming just coming away with the win.
Wow, Freeze channeling 2012 S1.6 form. That was him back at his best. Of course, SK Gaming taken right to the wire by CSGO Lounge, of course, being called up late in this matchup. I believe it was Penta that was supposed to play this morning. CSGO Lounge getting the call up quite late there, but of course, really fast out of the gates. They got away to a 5-0 start there and really put the pressure back on SK Gaming. It was from there, it was a really fast-paced arm wrestle between these two teams, and obviously SK Gaming winning out in the end there, but geez, that I guess if you had to describe the matchup, it would simply just be a fast-paced foot race from start to finish. There was really no finesse, there was really no slow-paced tactical approaches from both teams. They did do quite well in the breakdowns, but nonetheless, they were wrestling control of mid quite fast, really varying the tempo mid-round a lot, but the openings from both teams were really quite fast-paced, and I think that's just, there's no other way to put it. That was just how things were, and in the end, SK Gaming, on the back of some individual brilliance, coming out.
Yeah, and I mean, for SK, it's probably not even the way they wanted the game to go. They started very slowly. They made their way back into the game. They were down, I think, 5-0 very, very quickly, and then moved the half along to 9-6, and that was enough for them to eventually come out on their second half, on their CT side, just scraping through there with the 16-14 win. But I want to sort of focus more on, I think, as you said, the pace of the game, because there was no ability from either team on T side to just sit back and let the CTs dictate pace. Both teams on their T side were very keen on forcing the issue and getting things sped along nice and quick, catching players off guard. They changed the pace up quite well, both teams on their T side, so they were able to manipulate the timings of their hits very well within that fast structure of play. But generally speaking, it was all fast-paced action, which lends itself to lots of multi-fragging and great